Hello and welcome everyone. My name is Mona Yadav and in this video we are going to learn about force exerted by jet on moving plate. So now first is the case of force on flat vertical plate moving in the direction of jet. So this is the diagram where we can see that a jet of water striking a flat vertical plate. So this is the initial position of the flat vertical plate and these dotted lines are representing the final position of the flat vertical plate. So this figure shows the jet of water striking a flat vertical plate moving with a uniform velocity away from the jet. So this flat plate is moving away from the jet with a uniform velocity. So we can consider V as the velocity of jet, it is the absolute velocity, small a as the area of cross section of jet, u is the velocity of flat plate. Now in this case the jet does not strike the plate with the velocity V, but it strikes with the relative velocity, which is equal to the absolute velocity of jet minus the velocity of plate. That means the relative velocity of the jet with respect to plate is equal to V minus U. So jet is not striking the plate with the velocity V, but it is striking the plate with the velocity V minus U. So mass of water striking the plate per second is equal to rho into area of jet into velocity with which the jet strikes the plate. So it will be equal to rho into A into V minus U, as V minus U is the velocity with which the jet is striking the moving plate. Therefore, force exerted by the jet on the moving plate in the direction of jet will be equal to Fx equal to mass of water striking per second into initial velocity with which jet strikes minus final velocity. Therefore, Fx is equal to rho A V minus U into initial velocity with which the jet is striking in the direction of jet is V minus U only and final velocity is zero. So therefore, it will become Fx equals to rho A V minus U square. In this case, the work will be done by the jet on the plate as the plate is moving. So, as there is some movement, that means some work has been done. Therefore, work done needs to be calculated here. Whereas for the stationary plate, the work done is zero. Now, the work done per second by the jet on the plate will be equal to force into distance in the direction of force divided by time. Why we have divided by time? Because work done per second by the jet on the plate needs to be calculated. If it would have been simple work done, then we would have taken the formula as force into distance. But it is work done per second, therefore we need to take force into distance in the direction of force divided by time. So it will be equal to Fx into U, as force is Fx and distance divided by time is nothing but the velocity of plate. So Fx is equal to rho A V minus U square multiplied by U. So this will be the work done. If the value of rho for water is taken in SI units as 1000 kg per meter cube, the work will be done in Newton meter per second. So the term Newton meter per second is equal to watts. Now next is the force on inclined plate moving in the direction of jet. So now plate is inclined by an angle theta. So this is the diagram where we can see that V is the initial velocity of the jet, absolute velocity, theta is the angle between the jet and the plate, U is the velocity with which the plate is moving, and V minus U is the velocity with which the jet is striking the plate. So theta is the angle between jet and plate. Relative velocity will be equal to V minus U. The velocity with which the jet strikes becomes V minus U. Therefore, mass of water striking per second equals to rho A V minus U. Therefore, the force exerted by jet of water on the plate in the direction of normal to the plate is given as Fn, normal force equals to mass striking per second into initial velocity in the normal direction with which jet strikes minus final velocity. Therefore, Fn equals to rho A V minus U into V minus U sine theta minus U, because initial velocity in the direction of normal is not V minus U only, but it is V minus U sine theta. Therefore, Fn will be equal to rho A V minus U square sine theta. Now, this normal force Fn is resolved in two components, namely Fx and Fy in the direction of jet and perpendicular to the direction of jet respective. Therefore, Fx equals to Fn sine theta. So, rho A V minus U square sine square theta. and Fy is Fn cos theta. Therefore, it becomes rho Av minus u square sin theta cos theta. Now, work done per second by the jet on the plate is Fx into distance per second in the direction of x. Therefore, Fx into u. And again, by putting the value of Fx here, we will be getting rho Av minus u square sin square theta into u. So, this is nothing but the work done. Now, the unit of this work done is in Newton meter per second. Now, next is force on curved plate moving in the direction of jet. So, the force is exerted by the jet on the curved plate when the jet is striking the curved plate at the center. So, jet is striking the curved plate at the center and then it is deflecting by a certain angle. That angle of deflection is nothing but 180 minus theta. So, theta is the angle between plate and jet. And this relative velocity is inclined at an angle of theta. So, it will be having two components. So, now starting with the derivation. So, let V is the absolute velocity of jet. A is area of jet. U is velocity of plate in the direction of jet. So, relative velocity of jet of water or the velocity with which the jet strikes the curved plate is V minus U. If the plate is smooth and the loss of energy due to impact of jet is zero, then velocity with which the jet will be leaving the curved vane will be equal to V minus U. This velocity can be resolved in two components. One in the direction of jet and other perpendicular to the direction of jet. Therefore, component of the velocity in the direction of jet will be equal to minus of V minus U cos theta. Now, as this V velocity was going towards positive x direction and V minus U cos theta is going towards negative x direction, so, in order to equalize it, so we need to consider minus sign here. So, component of velocity in the direction perpendicular to the direction of jet will be equal to V minus U sin theta. Therefore, mass of water striking the plate will be equal to rho A V minus U. And force exerted by the jet of water on the curved plate in the direction of jet will be equal to Fx equals to mass striking per second into initial velocity with which jet strikes the plate in the direction of jet minus final velocity. So, it will be equal to rho Av minus u into V minus u minus of minus V minus u cos theta. Now, simplifying it, we will be getting rho Av minus u square into 1 plus cos theta. Now, work done by the jet on the plate per second will be equal to Fx into distance travel per second in the direction of x. That means Fx into u. So, by putting the value of Fx and multiplying it by u, we will get work done as rho Av minus u square into u into 1 plus cos theta. Now, next is force on an unsymmetrical moving curved plate when the jet strikes tangentially at one of the tips. So, now this is the diagram for the above condition. So, figure shows that a jet of water striking a moving curved plate, also called as vane, tangentially at one of the tips. So, this jet is striking the plate at one of the tip. That means we can consider that the jet is striking at point B. As the jet strikes tangentially, the loss of energy due to the impact of jet will be zero. In this case, as the plate is moving, the velocity with which the jet of water strikes is equal to the relative velocity of the jet with respect to the plate. Also, the plate is moving in different direction of the jet. The relative velocity at inlet will be equal to the vector difference of the velocity of jet and velocity of plate at inlet. So, now here we can see that the jet is striking at one of the end tangentially. So, this is the diagram. Now, in the diagram, we can see many notations. So, those notations are like this. V1 is velocity of jet at inlet. U1 is velocity of the plate at inlet. VR1 is relative velocity of jet and plate at inlet. Alpha is the angle between the direction of the jet and direction of motion of the plate, also called as guide blade angle. Theta is the angle made by the relative velocity with the direction of motion at the inlet, also called vane angle. VW1 and VF1 are components of the velocity of the jet V1 in the direction of motion and perpendicular to the direction of motion of vane respectively. VW1 is also called as velocity of whirl at inlet. VF1 is also known as velocity of flow at inlet. Similarly, we can have notations for the outlet side as well. So, the triangles ABD and EGH are called velocity triangles at inlet and outlet. So, now we will see each triangle in detail. So, velocity triangle at inlet. So, first of all, for drawing the velocity triangle at inlet, we should take a point A. So taking any point A, we need to draw a line AB. And the magnitude of the line AB should be equal to the velocity V1. Which means that line AB makes an angle of alpha with the horizontal line AD. So this alpha angle is made by the line AB with the line AD. And velocity V1 is at an angle alpha with respect to the line AD. Now next we need to draw a line AC, which should be equal to U1 in magnitude. So now we need to join point C with point B. So after joining the point C to B, this line CB represents the relative velocity of jet at inlet. So it is nothing but VR1, and this VR1 has taken an angle theta with respect to the line CD. So the relative velocity makes an angle of theta with the line CD. If the loss of energy at the inlet due to impact is zero, then CB must be in the tangential direction to the vane at inlet. So from B, draw a vertical line BD. So we have already drawn it. So from point B, we need to draw vertical line as we have drawn. And this line represents the velocity of flow at inlet. That means velocity value VF1. So this line BD represents VF1. Whereas line AD represents VW1 wall velocity. Line AC represents U1, AB represents V1, and CB represents VR1. Theta is the angle taken by VR1, whereas alpha is the angle which is made by velocity V1. Now similarly, we will be drawing velocity triangle at outlet. In order to have velocity triangle at outlet, we need to first consider a point E like this. So from point E, we need to draw a line EG. And this line's magnitude should be equal to the magnitude of VR2. And the angle taken by the line VR2 is nothing but phi. So theta and phi are the angles made by the relative velocities. So now phi is the angle which is made by VR2. Now we need to take a point F, and the distance between G to F should be equal to the velocity U2. That is blade velocity at outlet. Now, we need to join point E with F, and this line will represent the absolute velocity at outlet V2. Now, the angle made by velocity V2 is beta. Therefore, the line FH represents VW2, line EH represents VF2, and line EG represents VR2, line GF represents U2, line FE represents V2. So this is how we need to draw a outlet velocity triangle. Now if the vane is smooth and is having velocity in the direction of motion at inlet and outlet equal, then we have U1 equals to U2 equals to U. Also VR1 is equals to VR2. So now mass of water striking the vane per second equals to rho A VR1. So this is equation number 1. Now A is area of jet of water, VR1 is relative velocity at inlet. Therefore, force exerted by the jet in the direction of motion is Fx equals to mass of water striking per second into initial velocity with which jet strikes in the direction of motion minus final velocity of jet in the direction of motion. This is equation number 2. But initial velocity with which jet strikes is VR1, and component of this velocity in the direction of motion is VR1 cos theta, that is equal to VW1 minus U1. Similarly, the component of relative velocity at outlet in the direction of motion is minus VI2 cos phi. So, which is also equal to minus of U2 plus VW2. So, negative sign is taken as the component of VR2 in the direction of motion is in opposite direction. So, substituting equation 1 and all above values of velocities in equation 2, we get Fx is equals to rho A VR1 into VW1 minus U1 minus of minus U2 plus VW2. After simplifying, we will be getting rho A VR1 into VW1 plus VW2. And why this is so? Because U1 is equals to U2. Therefore, minus U1 and plus U2 got cancelled. Therefore, equation 3 is true only when angle beta shown in figure is acute angle. But if beta is 90 degree, then VW2 is 0. And then the equation 3 becomes as Fx equals to rho A VR1 into VW1. Now, if beta is an obtuse angle, the expression for fx will become fx equals to rho a vr1 vw1 minus vw2. Thus, in general, fx is written as fx equals to rho a vr1 into vw1 plus minus vw2. So, this will be plus when beta is acute angle. This will be minus when beta will be obtuse angle. And this vw2 term will not be there when beta is equal to 90 degree. So, work done per second on the vane by the jet is equals to force into distance per second in the direction of force. Now, it is equal to fx into u. So, rho a vr1 into vw1 plus minus vw2 into u. Therefore, work done per second per unit weight of the fluid striking per second is given by rho a vr1 vw1 plus minus vw2 into u divided by weight of fluid striking per second and unit for which will be newton meter per newton. So, it is 1 by g into vw1 plus minus vw2 into u. Now, work done per second per unit mass of fluid striking per second. Work done per second per unit mass. It was per unit weight. This is per unit mass of the fluid striking per second. Will be equal to vw1 plus minus vw2 into u in newton meter per kg. So, this g term will not be here. Now, last is efficiency of jet. So, efficiency, we know that it is output upon input. It is also equal to work done per second on the vane divided by initial kinetic energy per second of the jet. So, it is equal to rho a vr1 into vw1 plus minus vw2 into u divided by half of mv1 square. So, it is initial kinetic energy of the jet per second. Now, where m is mass of fluid per second in the jet, that is rho a v1, and v1 is initial velocity of jet. So, putting the value of m as rho a v1 here, we will be getting eta equals to rho a vr1 vw1 plus minus vw2 into u divided by half of rho a v1 into v1 square. So, this is the final expression for velocity, which can be expressed like eta equals to rho a vr1 into vw1 plus minus vw2 into u divided by half of rho a v1 cube. So, this is all about efficiency of jet. Thank you.